As the dust settles in Kabul, the deep sense of loss from Saturday's brutal bomb blast becomes clear. Grieving families burying their loved ones on the mountaintop, most of the victims young schoolgirls.
While we share our grief and mourning with the families in respect of the martyrs of the terrorist attack on innocent students in Logar province and the innocent female school students in Kabul, I am announcing a public mourning on Tuesday this week.
The violence marked the latest in a series of assaults aimed at Afghanistan's mostly Shiite community, the Hazaras, at the hands of Sunni extremists. As far as the government is concerned, the blame lies squarely with one organization.
The Taliban are behind this criminal and unforgivable act of terror.
For their part, the Taliban have continued to deny carrying out any major offensives targeting civilians since signing their own peace deal with the United States last February. But the group continued to clash with US-backed Afghan security forces, especially in Helmand province, where thousands have been forced to flee their homes. On Monday, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani announced he would agree to a three-day ceasefire, called on by the Taliban themselves to mark the end of Ramadan. It came just hours after a bus hit a roadside mine in the southern Zabul province, with the blast killing 11 people.
When our vehicle approached the checkpoint, the bomb exploded. Many people were martyred and injured. I saw that the people's hands and feet had fallen to the ground. They were not themselves.
Violence has surged since the United States began pulling the last of its troops from Afghanistan on May the 1st, with critics warning the withdrawal has prompted Islamist militants to make a grab for power.
French social